These are the big plays of the SEC. Brought to you by Frigidaire, the home environment division of General Motors. And featuring the football teams of the Southeastern Conference. I'm Bill Flemming. These are the big plays of the SEC, the spectacular moments in the 1974 season of the Southeastern Conference. And Frigidaire, the home environment division of General Motors, is very proud to be bringing you this exciting half hour of football. Today we salute the teams of the SEC. Our salute begins with Ralph Shug Jurton, beginning his 25th year at his alma mater, Auburn. At Alabama, Paul Bear Bryant enters his 18th season as the head coach of the Crimson Tide. Charlie McClendon has been the top man at Louisiana State University for 13 years. Vince Dooley of Georgia is in his 12th year. Doug Dickey in his 6th year at the University of Florida. And at Tennessee, also in his 6th year, Bill Battle. Fran Kersey at the University of Kentucky has completed 2 exciting years. At Vanderbilt, Steve Sloan produced a winning team in 74, then was named the head coach at Texas Tech for next year. His successor at Vandy, Fred Pancoast. Bob Tyler starts his 3rd season at Mississippi State. And at Ole Miss, Ken Cooper begins his 2nd year at the helm. So stay with us now for the big plays of the SEC. And we'll be underway right after this word from Frigidaire.
From the General Motors Proving Grounds comes Chevrolet, Pontiac, Oldsmobile, Buick, and Cadillac. The same engineering and design skills behind all these fine General Motors cars are in all these Frigidaire appliances. Refrigerators, Frigidaire washers, dryers, room air conditioners, dishwashers, and the newest member of the Frigidaire General Motors family, one of the easiest ways to cook since cooking began, the first touch and cook range in history with solid state controls. General Motors' reputation for dependability is behind all of these Frigidaire appliances. When you put your hard-earned money into Frigidaire appliances, you always enjoy the feeling of knowing you did the right thing.
If there's one word that describes the SEC football atmosphere, it's enthusiasm. It's a fun time for all. And the most fun comes from the big play. It's that wonderful feeling that the players have for their teammates who have accomplished the ultimate in football, and that, of course, is scoring a touchdown. SEC football players are second to none when it comes to celebrating. For the next few moments, we'd like to pay special tribute to the seniors of 74. At Mississippi State, number 35 is worn by cornerback Steve Freeman, a 3-year letterman from Memphis, who is the leading interceptor on the Bulldog squad. Number 70 of the Bulldogs was defensive end Jimmy Webb, a player who came to Mississippi with a fine reputation, and he fulfilled his college ambitions by twice being named to the All-SEC team, and he was an academic All-American. Number 18 of Mississippi State named the SEC's most valuable player, Rocky Felker. He ran for 7 touchdowns, passed for 8 others, and turned in a 1,593-yard total offense performance, tops in the league. On the receiving end of this Felker pass, another departing senior, Mel Barkham, second leading pass catcher on the team. At Tennessee, the Volunteers will miss their fine defensive tackle number 70, Robert Pulliam, as well as their two-time All-America place-kicking star, Ricky Townsend. During his 3 years, his foot accounted for a total of 171 points. They called him the Artful Dodger, number 7, quarterback Condridge Holloway, the top scrambling quarterback in the history of the SEC. Talk about big plays. Every time Holloway got his hands on the ball, he was liable to turn it into a wild, freewheeling touchdown play. At Mississippi, the Marco brothers, number 31, Pete, and number 48, Greg, were a couple who turned in exceptional defensive performances Saturday after Saturday. And number 11 for the Rebels was worn by Kenny Lyons, senior quarterback from Biloxi, who had an outstanding senior year, led the team in touchdowns and in total offense. Kenny Lyons was also named to the academic All-America squad. At Florida, number 55, Ralph Ortega, and number 43, Glenn Cameron, have been a linebacking duel for 3 memorable years. They actually have been playing together since high school days at Coral Gables. And this is a defensive combination that has to rank as the best in Gator history. Number 28, Randy Talbot, is another Coral Gables product who made great contributions to the Florida defensive strength. He led the SEC in interceptions with 7. And there will be a special place in the memory of Florida fans for the Gators' pint-sized receiver, Lee McGriff. During his senior year, he caught 36 passes, 7 for touchdowns like this, to lead the SEC in receiving. He gained 19 yards every time he touched the football. On defense, the Kentucky Wildcats always got a top performance from number 48, Rick Fromm, helped out here by a fine newcomer, number 97, a freshman, Art Still. Quarterback of the Wildcats, Mike Fanuzzi, twice was named as the top offensive player in televised games. Here he completes one of his 4 touchdown passes to huge tight end, senior Elmore Stevens. Mike's greatest asset was his strong running and ball handling. Here, he makes it look easy against Vanderbilt. The Crimson Tide of Alabama graduated only 7 starting seniors, including number 62, Randy Hall, here with number 98, returning All-American, Leroy Cook. Number 62 always seemed to be in the thick of battle. At 233 pounds, this native of Huntsville goes down as one of the best in Tide history. He was also an all-A pre-med student. Number 54, Mike Dubose, another 3-year veteran who gave so much to the Alabama defense during his career. And how about number 34, cornerback Mike Washington, a man Bear Bryant called the complete football player. A strong, solid tackler who was a quick-reacting player, and he could move when he got the football. At the end of the season, Mike was named to 3 All-America squads. And a word of praise here is due for Alabama's senior center, Sylvester Croom, who played so well at a position that doesn't get much publicity. The only offensive star not returning for the Tide is number 26, Randy Billingsley, a hard-running back who combined with Calvin Culliver and Willie Shelby to give Alabama one of the strongest wishbones in America. Vanderbilt's number 58, Tom Scheffler, wasn't very big as defensive ends go, but he could hit. On offense, Vanderbilt had the experience at quarterback with veteran David Lee, number 8. Although perhaps more known for his strong passing, he proved he could run, scoring 5 touchdowns in his 79 carries. As a passer, He accounted for 7 more scores and posted a 53% completion mark. This one goes to returning All-American Barry Burton. And number 44, senior Jamie O'Rourke, deserves special acclaim as the team's leading scorer. The Georgia Bulldogs don't have to be reminded of the role that number 24 tailback Horace King played in the success of the Georgia offense. He led the team in scoring with 72 points on 12 touchdowns, and he often made them the spectacular way. Defense has always been a prideful part of the game at Auburn. Number 26, Jim McKinney, typifies the kind of defensive player the Tigers developed. Hard, muscular, and quick. Here he intercepts and returns against Texas in the Gator Bowl. Much credit for Auburn's great defense goes to number 53 All-America linebacker Ken Burnage, as well as his co-defensive star, number 42 defensive back Mike Fuller. A final salute, too, to number 80 tight end Dan Nugent of Auburn. The LSU Tigers are proud to have had number 80 linebacker Bo Harris with them for the past 3 years, as well as senior quarterback number 9 Billy Broussard, who is the team's total offense leader. And lastly, the final player in our senior salute, LSU's number 48 Brad Davis, a co-captain of the team, the leading rusher, the leading scorer, and an academic All-American. A fine list of accomplishments to leave behind after 3 memorable years as a fighting Tiger. SEC football enthusiasm is contagious. The drum majors have it. The bands have it. The fans have it. The players have it. And certainly, the girls have it. Doesn't it? Well, it is inspiring, and it certainly was to Kentucky's freshman flash, Ken Northington. He was so whipped up by Wildcat enthusiasm that the very first time he ever carried the ball in a college game, he exploded for this 80-yard touchdown run. The fact that a freshman could do this against major opposition is quite a feat, but it speaks well of the younger players we'll be seeing in the SEC in the upcoming season. Nowhere is the accent on youth more apparent than in Southeastern Conference football. At Ole Miss, for instance, they're counting on 53 players back from last year's team, led by All-America tackle candidate number 74, Ben Williams. This 253-pound giant was one of the most feared defenders during play of the 74 season. Stronger and smarter in 75, he ought to be something. And on offense, just keep your eye on number 25, tailback James Reed, who led the Rebels in rushing, who has 9-4 speed. And it makes him one of the fastest backs not only in the league, but also in the nation. At LSU, the Fighting Tigers have an exciting group of young players to look forward to. Carl Otis Trimble, number 3, shared much of the quarterbacking load with Billy Broussard last year. Here's an example of what he can do. A touchdown pass to number 89, Brad Boyd. A Another sophomore who saw action in all 11 games in 74 was number 16, Terry Robiskie. Terry's a hard-working performer who contributed four big touchdowns to the Tigers' attack in 74. LSU could also boast of super freshman star number 31, Clint Burrell, who won himself a starting job as a cornerback and who proved he could fly with this 78-yard punt return for a touchdown. At Vanderbilt, Steve Sloan leaves new coach Fred Pancoast some fine stars. Heading the list is as versatile a player as there is in the country, number 89, Randy Burton. His favorite play was the end-around last season. But he also caught three touchdown passes and ran for another and did all the team punting. He averaged over 40 yards per kick. Quarterback Fred Fisher returns for 75. Hopefully for Vandy fans, he'll be healthy for the entire season. A year ago, he missed five games due to injuries. Defensively, number 7, Jay Chesley, will anchor the secondary. If he does as well as he did in 74, the Commodores won't have any worries there. He picked off five enemy passes, returned two for touchdowns, and he handled a lot of the punt return chores. Vandy's most dangerous offensive threat will be Lonnie Sadler, a 195-pound, highly charged running back. Watch this move that he makes on a wet field. The fact is, the entire Southeastern Conference is filled with excellent runners. At Tennessee, they sing the praises of their super soft of 74, Stanley Morgan. Morgan's power and swiftness enabled him to post an average of nearly 6 yards every time he touched the ball. His 14 touchdowns for 84 points led the team in scoring. He oftentimes wound up taking more punishment from his jubilant teammates than he did from the opposition. Number 43, Tommy West, may not have received the rave notices that Holloway and Morgan got, but he was always in there at his tight end post, blocking and catching passes in clutch situations. Here's one of his 14 receptions. Mike Gales, number 43, didn't have as spectacular a sophomore season as Stanley Morgan. Nevertheless, he did play in all 11 games, and he scored four touchdowns, and he proved to be a durable runner. At Mississippi State, number 40, running back Walter Packer also had a noteworthy sophomore season. He wound up the year just 6 yards short of the 1,000-yard mark to lead the SEC in total rushing yards, and that's impressive by anybody's standards. Then there's number 25, Dennis Johnson, who raised a lot of eyebrows among the opposing coaches with his freshman season. He clicked off seven touchdowns against some of the best defenses in the country. The Bulldogs had a fierce defender, number 37, Bobby Wallace. More than once, he frustrated receivers by reaching up to snare a pass, and that always made him popular with his offensive teammates. All of the day's work, says Bobby. Blue is the color seen most often in Lexington, home of the Kentucky Wildcats. It was usually a streak of blue whenever number 40, Sonny Collins, got his hands on the ball. After a fantastic sophomore season in which he led the SEC in rushing and scoring, he started off great in 74. Through eight games, he led the conference. Then disaster struck in the Vanderbilt game. His ankle was broken on this scoring play, and he was through for the season. He still wound up as the conference leader in rushing average with over 107 yards a game. 1975 should see him returning to top four. It seems that most of the outstanding freshmen in 74 were offensive players, but at number 50, Jim Kovach, Kentucky had a fine defensive player. He was the only freshman to make the all-academic team. And returning for his senior year in 75 is number 41, Steve Compassi, one of the low-to-the-ground runners who's hard to knock off his feet. He's also the type of player who dares you to do it. A spirited, aggressive player who in his own personality reflected the entire attitude of the Kentucky team. In a word, the Wildcats are tough. At Gainesville, the Florida Gators are talking about their first SEC championship. Not without reason either, especially with a kicking specialist like David Posey, who can win the tight ones with his right foot. Back at the Florida offensive controls at quarterback is number 8, Don Gaffney. He had the Gators clicking along at better than a 400-yard-per-game clip. until all of a sudden the wheels fell off back in November, and they lost to Georgia and Kentucky back-to-back. If we can clean up the mistakes, says Coach Dickey, we can take it all. Gaffney can run, as you could see, but he can also throw. And when there's a receiver out there like freshman Tony Green, the results can be volcanic. With Green's speed and the power and the savvy of number 35 Jimmy Dubose at fullback, the Gators could realize their dreams of an SEC title in 75. Defensively, the Gators are solid in the secondary with Alvin Cowens coming off a strong sophomore year. And when Alvin intercepts, he makes everybody happy. Like their mascot, the Bulldogs of Georgia present a fierce defensive image. Number 55, Sylvester Bowler, could well be dubbed Bowler the Bulldog. He made his tenaciousness felt as a sophomore last year, and his 235 pounds will crunch more than a few people in 75. It's not easy for a sophomore quarterback to cut it in a tough league like the SEC, but Matt Robinson of Georgia came through his sophomore season with high marks. He ran for 7 touchdowns. He had a total offense of 1,582 yards. That's number 2 in the conference. What's more, he could take the punishment. He saw action in all 11 games. He also threw 8 touchdown passes, 3 of those to another sophomore, a slippery little split end who wore number 82, Gene Washington. This Robinson to Washington combination will give their opponents fits in the upcoming season of 1975. Like Robinson of Georgia, Auburn's Phil Gargis proved as a sophomore that he has the class to be a big league quarterback. He was named the most valuable player in the Gator Bowl game. When he passed, he made it count, hitting for 5 touchdowns and 35 completions. The Tigers occasionally came up with some razzle-dazzle to keep the defense loose. Gargis to Neal, who airmails it to wide receiver number 82, Ed Butler, who'll be returning this fall. If tailback Mitzi Jackson isn't one of the slickest running backs in the country, Coach Jordan says his name isn't Shug. Jackson wears number 22 for Auburn, and you won't need a program to tell who he is. One final word about War Eagle. Patrolling a defensive end is number 99, Liston Edens, who may just prove to be in his senior year as pesky as the name of his hometown. He comes from Brat, Florida. One might imagine that after winning 4 straight conference championships, there might be a tendency at Alabama to have a ho-hum attitude toward the upcoming season. You won't find any yawning, however, in Tuscaloosa. With backs like number 30, Willie Shelby, in action, look out, especially when you combine him with his running mate, number 33, Calvin Culliver. Between them, they combine for 12 touchdowns. And it's hard for defenses to figure out a way to stop this tandem offense. Culliver is a sophomore, Shelby is a junior, and each has moves that are as unpredictable as a rock dance. Up, down, sideways, they give the Tide the offensive beat. Defensively, number 47, Woodrow Lowe, is back for his final season, and he's determined to win All-America status for a 3rd straight year in 1975. The Tide has pride is no idle saying, and there's a bigger desire than ever to win a 5th title in a row and to go to a major bowl game and win. The armament for battle is certainly there. It's no wonder the coach, Paul Bear Bryant, feels as he does about the upcoming season. When the question was put to him, who's going to win the Southeastern Conference title, his answer was uncomplicated and direct.
I think we're going to win it. First time I've ever said that, but we're just going to win it. And I think we're going to win a bowl game.
An optimistic prediction from Coach Bear Bryant. As the praises of Alabama are sung, however, we also know there are 9 hungry SEC foes determined to stem the tide. That's what makes a great race.
Now, from Frigidaire, the cold specialists, ultimate relief from common thirst, the Frigidaire Refreshment Center, the only refrigerator that helps cure thirst 4 ways on the outside of the door in the form of 2 juices, chilled water, and ice. So for fast relief, buy a 20-cubic foot, 100% frost-proof Frigidaire Refreshment Center refrigerator and take as directed.
You are entering the Research and Design Center of General Motors, where you are about to see a revolutionary new development. The Frigidaire Touch and Cook range with solid-state controls. It has no buttons, no knobs, no dials. Just touch it on, touch it off. And its ceramic top and self-cleaning oven make it one of the easiest ways to cook since cooking began.
This is Bill Flemming speaking for Frigidaire, the Home Environment Division of General Motors, and thanking you for being with us for the big plays of the SEC. We'll look forward to seeing you in the season of 75 for more Southeastern Conference football.